Hi, in this tutorial we will talk about the VRay RenderID render element. Here, for example, I have this rendered image here. If I go to this drop-down list and choose VRay RenderID, you can see that each object in the scene has a distinct mate color. Here, for example, this chair is a group, is not a single mesh, so each object in the group has a distinct color. This is very useful to isolate objects in a post-production software like Photoshop and do some adjustments to the colors of the objects. So to do this, so now let's see how to set it up. It's very easy. In the render setup dialog, go to render elements, click add, and look for VRay RenderID. Always make sure that this is on so that we can see this render element in the VRay frame buffer. You don't have to worry about all of these. The node handle is just, you know, when you create any object in Max, internally every object has an identifier, like an ID, so Max can identify these objects to do various things. So if you click this, the colors will be generated using those Max IDs, identifiers. But if you don't do this, actually VRay will create a render ID during render time and will assign the mate color, so you can just leave it. So now after doing this, all you have to do is just click render. Okay, now the rendering is finished. We will see how we can use this file in Photoshop. If you click here, first save your image. Let's call it V1. I will choose TIFF. You can leave the default. And now go to VRay render ID. Also, I will choose TIFF. Open the file in Photoshop. Drag the ID on top of the image. Click enter. Now I can use the magic wand. While this is selected, click, for example, let's say on this, keep the tolerance low, for example, 1 or 2, so that when you click on a pixel, it will only select colors that matches exactly the colors of this pixel. So if I click here, and I left contiguous off, so that because you know this part of the column is under the table, so if this is on, the selection will stop where it hits this white color here. But if this is off, it will choose all colors in the scene that matches this pixel. So anyway, while this is selected, go to the rendered image. You can turn off this layer. Right click, you know, you can do the adjustments here directly, but I prefer to keep the original intact. So right click and choose layer via copy. Now, if I turn off this layer, you can see that now I created a separate layer for this, so I can adjust this without affecting the original. Here, click this button here and choose, for example, let's say hue and saturation to affect only the layer under it and not everything else below. Click this this option here. Now this hue saturation will affect only this layer under it, and now you can do some adjustments. And so every time you want to select a different element, you have to go here, use the magic wand, click, go to the original, right click, and choose layer via copy, and do your adjustments. So anyway, this is everything for this tutorial. I hope you like it and you found it useful. If you like this video, please press the like button and subscribe to the channel, and see you on the next video. Thank you.